Hey everyone, Azu here, and welcome back to Nioh on PS4. Yes, I am still very, very happy. With this game. And I know the layout of this level pretty much off by heart, so good luck hiding stuff from me when it comes to Kodama. As long as I don't run off into the depths below, we should be good. You can destroy boxes, obviously, for benefit. Pick this up. Right. I'm hoping they haven't changed the beta positions too much. That would be really annoying. Hey! It's quite an awful lot. That hurt. Wait, stop blocking. That's cheating. Oh dear. Anyway. Take care of him. And thus we begin what I like to call the I must have everything. Kind of gameplay, where I'm going to make it my mission to acquire one of everything. Every item. No revenants though, I'm very disappointed. Oh, there we go. People did die. Brilliant. You? Oh, you're an NPC. Hi. Yep. You're a twat. That hurt. That's what I think of you. Yeah, weapons are usually good for that kind of thing. Come on, Iske the brick. Come on. That hurt. Bit rusty. And a key. Booyah. Alright, 8 glory. That's cool. What? I don't know what that does, but I'll take it. Son, you ain't killing anyone. Oh, I don't have the backstab skill yet. Alright. Sometimes you just have to do a really heavy attack and beat the crap out of them. And you're an idiot. So you deserve what's coming to you. Hey, he's where I remember him. Good. This bodes well. Hey, little buddy. Oh, buddy, I'm sorry. Hey. Sorry about that. See ya. So he'll pop back to the shrine and you get, when you find a new shrine, I believe, the more more Kodama you have there, the more Amrita you get when you pray at a new shrine. And, you know, and you also, the more Kodama you have, the more Kodama blessings you have access to. Which is always nice. Jingaza. Useless. Go this way. Check this out. Righty. The man who killed me more times than I like to admit in the alpha. I never quite got the hang of dodging, and so that guy killed me more times than I like to admit. Also, I apologise if my voice sounds more whiny and stuffy than usual. Bit of a congested nose issue at the moment. There used to be a guy here, there's not now. I'm happy with that. But, yeah, so... Bit congested and stuffy at the moment. You fool. I'll take your arrows. They're mine now. Black steel axe. Well, it's... That tree popping. Yep. Not the tree, but the plants next to it. Okay. Yep. Nah, that's cool. They have promised updates and stuff, like PvP will be added in as I believe a free update at a later date, because they're trying to figure out the best way to deliver PvP. So we will see how that goes. Because they, by the sounds of it, they don't just want to shoehorn PvP into the game and then just have it be really lame. You know, they want to make it work, so they're gonna work on it, see what works best, and then they'll implement it later on. Which, honestly, I'm okay with, because. Like, I really like the game, and I would hate for them to rush parts of it just to make people happy. So, if it means we have to wait to get good PvP, then I'm fine with it. It's like New Game Plus. At the moment, there's no New Game Plus in the game, because they said it wouldn't be in the game at release, because they are working on the best thing, because it's like a 40-hour game to begin with, and, you know, your general first playthrough, so we will explore that way, but... Hello. Sorry, you have to die. It's just how it is. Sorry. So I'm not gonna keep this DLC armor on the entire game. Like, even though I can increase the level of it and stuff, I'm gonna try other things, because it'd be unfair for me to use DLC weapons and armor the entire game. I just think that'd be kind of unfair, and not just to the people watching and stuff, but like to the game itself, because it wants you to use what the game gives you. Speaking of which, Kodama occasionally wander away from their shrine to become lost. If you tell these lost Kodama the way back, they return to the shrine. Yeah, you get extra elixirs and stuff too. So that's neat. I like that. You lied to me. I switched to it and said it was better. It was wrong. Oh well. So we have two ways to go. We can head that way, which, if you remember, is the way to the first encounter with a large sort of yokai creature who is guarding the body to the, which has the key to progress in the level. Or we can go this way and then hang a left and kick down that ladder that guy was dead underneath. You know, he was like, oh, you know, I had, you know, oh, the ladder, don't tell me he's running away. So I'm thinking I will do the shrine route to begin with, just so I have a nice loop back. Come on. Yes, heavy stance. That's the way to go. Use all of your ki. I will not disagree with this strategy. And you're dead. I'll eat an elixir, why not? And you're up there. But I can't get you. And as you can see on the mini-map, I can see where the enemies are. Courtesy of the guardian spirit I have chosen, which is very handy. So instead of going... Excuse you. So instead of going the way to actually, you know, progress, we're gonna hop down here. We're gonna go in here and nab this. And we're gonna nab this. There's the enemy there, but we'll ignore him for now. Instead, descend. Hold down X and you slide down a ladder. This guy should drop fire bombs, I think, if I remember. Yes. So this ladder the guy was dead under, near the shrine, you have to kick it down. And if you drop, and you run around here, lo and behold, it's a shrine. And yes, praying at a shrine will cause everything to respawn, but since we now have the sort of shortcut, I think we're fine. Yeah, I think we're fine. Well, Memory Charm. Living Weapon Attack Enhancement. Earth Defense. Or no, Attack versus Earth, isn't it? No, yeah, Earth Resistance and Resistance to the Yokai Realm draining your ki. Yeah. So, this is good. This is all good stuff. And I'll just quickly move the cursor over these so I don't have the annoying little arrows. Key recovery, which would be good if you're going into a yokai place. But that's not why we're here. We're here to level up. So how many levels can I get? 3 levels. I can bung 3 into skill. I can bung 3 into spirit, which increases my yokai realm resistance. Okay, magic. That's quite surprising, actually. Jesus Christ. 3 into body, which gives me the most health. Heart gives me some ki. This is carry strength, basically. Axes like it. Even though it says strength affects axes, I mean, that gives my axe 7, but stamina gives it 6. It also gives me 2.6 equipment. So, it's hard. I'll get spirit to 8 for the bonuses. And 1 into magic just to get my yokai realm sort of defenses up. See how that rolls for me. So now I've got 3 samurai points to funnel into. Where's the backstab? What do we want? What do we want? What do we want? Well, dual swords would be good. Sign of the cross. Oh, certain skills transfer over, like, because I got flux for the spear, and that applies for the axe and the dual sword. So there are ones that are shared, which is always nice. Oh, that cost 3, did it? Okay. That is annoying. Ninja. Long range weapons. Yeah, give me some of that. And we'll go with kunai for now. Why not? And then on your magic, we have 5 skill points. So these are mystic arts. They're more passives. So you know, this extends skill and item duration. This one, it makes casting stuff really quick. Stuff like that. Okay, so there's Yokai Realm plus 100. Yes. Just yes. That's useful, but I think I'll go on your magic capacity. Because that's just so much better. So now if I go pray, there's now the ready jutsu, which allows you to assign certain things, and your capacity is how many things you can have equipped. So kunai takes up 4 cost, but we only have 3 capacity, so we can't use it yet. Conversely, shuriken only uses 3. You can hold 7 at a time. They replenish at a I think when you pray at a shrine, I think they replenish. Yeah. And on your magic, because I did the 4, I've now got 9 magic capacity, which is really good. No DLC boons. Summon visitor is because I'm offline, I can't do that. Network connection. Might as well, if it gives me more revenants to fight, then I'm up for it. Yeah, cool. I can't really say if it's PS Plus dependent. I don't think so, but probably not the best to quote me on that, because I might be wrong and I don't want to disappoint anyone. Oh yeah, so up and down on a ladder, as I said, hold down X to slide down, but as you're climbing up, if you hold down X, you climb faster at the expense of using up some of your ki. Hello. Here we go. These dwellers can actually drop some pretty good stuff. So there's this guy here, who you're not meant to see. You're meant to run in and attack that guy at the corpse, and this guy's meant to spring and attack from behind and trick you. Also, don't underestimate the dwellers. I can't stress that enough. Once they go on all fours, they can do a leap attack. If they do that and they connect with you, they will knock you onto your back and either beat you over the head with a rock or vomit poison on you, and trust me, neither of them are particularly good. Also, but when they miss, you can do that. Now, things like wood are smithing materials, so if you want to use the blacksmith to create weapons and armor, or if you want to upgrade things, you need smithing materials. Now, obviously, certain missions, you'll be able to tell what you get, so you can most likely farm them in certain missions. But yeah, so if you want to make a bow, for example, you're most likely going to need a lot of wood. You want armor, you're going to need ingots. Things like that, you know. Smithing tests. Text. Sorry. So this will allow you, I believe, to forge these DLC weapons. Wait, what? Japan's great. What? Wait. Yeah, Nioh stuff, Onryoki, yeah. Japan's greatest soldier armor set. Huh. I'm gonna have to check that out. Anyway, I died here, I'm pretty sure, as a NPC. Because same sort of thing in the Hey, good armor. Same sort of thing in the demos. There were revenants put in that were just AIs as basically just as examples. It was sort of a here's how it would work sort of thing. Like, hey, this is what we're going for with our multiplayer. And honestly, it did get the idea across, and let me tell you, you might be thinking, oh, they're just AI controlled stuff, they'd be piss easy. No, they're not. Some of them are bloody hard. Okay, so you're up here, you are Arrow Man. So I'm gonna high stance axe you to death. I need to axe you a question. That was terrible. Anywho, moving on from my bad jokes, there's a man over there, and there's an archer over there, and I don't have any goddamn bows, so I can't snipe the archer. I get to play the dodging game. There used to be a guy in here. People must have thought he was cheap. I didn't mind him. I mean, it was kind of unfair to have him sort of dash out and attack you, but he wasn't too difficult, you know? Like, if you got used to him, then it was sort of like, oh yeah, there's a guy there. Oh, thank God, finally! Yeah, so this stuff, wonderful. But no, longbow! I have a longbow now. I can defend myself. Oh, happy days. So, we've explored a fair bit so far. There's only a bit more to go, as far as I'm concerned, before we hit the second stage. Like, second part of the stage, I mean, because there's obviously the You kill the yokai, and then you get the key, and then you go through the door. So I can get one level, I can put into spirit, I can get 30 yokai realm. I'm gonna put it into stamina. I have a dream of using heavy armor and still dashing around like a lightweight. It won't happen, but hey, a man can dream. Good times. Come on. Yeah, you're an idiot. Cool. So nab this. Which is an arrow. Your bow from the shack, the one I borrowed. Yeah. Borrowed. So grab this. Samurai's locks. Which are 2 samurai skill points. That's what they do. They're an item that you get, and there used to be a Kodama here in the alpha, but they moved it. You consume it, and you get samurai points. is cool. I like that. Anywho, so instead of going the way we were going, because I was just going to drop us off at the shack we need to get to, instead... Oh, shit, nuggets. There we go. One day, I will aim properly. But today is not that day. So yeah, we're gonna go this way. Primarily because, well... It's just another way to the same place. But... Go away. This way, we get to see what's the rest in here before we reach the shack with the gate. Sorry, I lost my train of thought there for a second. Right, so there's a guy in this shack, there's two folks over there. So if we can snipe one of them, then we can piss off the other, and we can shoot him in the face too. Then run past here, annoy him, take care of him, because he really shouldn't have picked the fight, but he was very committed to his job. And the lockbox, what have you got for me? Spirit Stone, Foot Soldier Spear, and here's Roy. Oh, no, here's Zaya Roy, sorry. I got that wrong. There's Spearman. There's this thing, which is Spirit Stone. Destroy boxes. You can find money in them. Use money to buy stuff from the blacksmith. It has nothing to do with leveling up or anything. That's all on Amrita that you collect. So, you know, there's that. Trying to think, is there anywhere else that could be that there could be a Kodama? I don't think so. Taro the Brave. Rionosuke the Loud. Okay. So if you were going the way where like before I dropped down, you know, I was on that high bit after that second shrine. You could drop down and then come from away over there, and sort of come around and then come around here and then this way and then come along here. But you could snipe them from over there. But this way you can't do that, so... Fun times for all. No one? Really? I shot your friend in the face. Hello. Really, no one cares. Oh, you care. Okay. This was a poor decision. One down. Why did I do this? So contrary to what I'm doing, it's actually, as I said, a really bad idea to take on multiple people. Even though it is possible, it is generally considered a poor decision, because everything hurts, everything does a lot of damage, and they can gang up on you. And it's not fun. What? Someone? Oh, you! Archer Man, hello. I keep accidentally pressing the X button for too long, instead of dodging, I run. Yeah, that's kind of irritating. And that's just an item. Okay, good. I don't need to worry about that. It's not a Kodama I'm missing, thank God. I like getting everything on my first run through. I know it's silly to expect I can, but I can hope. And over here, there is a Kodama back here. Okay, you're new. I don't remember you being here. But off you pop. Then it is this. Yes, yes it will. This guy, Nishi Hironoshin. Eh. I'm sure that there's titles and prestige and all that related to defeating revenants, but I'll get to that. Oh yeah, much like Dark Souls 2, wells are a thing you can hit, so don't forget to get your items from them. Hey birdie! Okay, yeah, that one's safe, but I'm gonna need to steal that from you. There's also different qualities of wood, by the way, so you can get normal wood and quality wood, so keep that in mind. Prestige points and titles. What are you on about? Okay, so has anyone played Borderlands 2? Does anyone have any experience with the badass system in Borderlands 2? If so, you're gonna get the grip of this really quickly. So, this is a similar thing. You get prestige points, and then with your points, you can choose one of four assigned effects, and they cycle, so you can't just constantly level up one specific thing, because it'll just cycle it, and then you have to choose other ones until it comes back through the rotation. But yeah, so it's that kind of system. So I can choose magic power plus 2, durability of living weapons plus 50, luck plus 3, plus 5, probably. Living weapon durability, actually. Yeah. Alright, title list. Quiet one. Alright, yeah. Cool. Clear a main mission without wearing any armor. Well, when I leveled up and coming back. Same with this. Yep. Oh, sod off. Killing any enemy other than the boss? God damn it. Alright. Yep. That's gonna be fun. But anyway, destroy these for easy escape. Okay, that's a door. So open this just so I can come back and escape if I die. So that's a yokai cloud. A yokai will come out of that when you get too close. This and these just for the fun of it. Signpost talisman. They're sort of good for leaving a path. Hello. Yeah, you're the same one that was in the alpha and the and beta. You're nothing fancy. You're already out of key somehow. Yep. So yeah, he's nothing really special, he's just big and ugly. I did not purify that correctly at all. Yeah, that was stupid. Ooh, Jesus. Okay. I really should be a bit more careful. Oh, I can't wait till I get the using key pulse while dodging. Because that's so helpful. Oh, that's a grab attack, by the way. That hurts. Hello. Yeah. Right. Well, you're a happy man, aren't you? I mean, the thinnest of lines separates human from demon. Those who let their emotions run out of control may find themselves so transformed, for one could say a demon dwells inside all of us. The agitated souls of those drawn into the chaos of war are particularly susceptible now once tranquil lands are filled with the transformed. Right, so war caused everyone to go to hell. Keto residence. Brilliant. Through we hop. Then there's this. Horokudama. Now, Horokudama and Kayakodama are... they're both firebombs. So, Kayakudama are normal firebombs, and Horokudama are black firebombs. Essentially. To use a Dark Souls equivalent. Alrighty. Now there's a Kodama there. And to do that, we drop down here. Guide him back to the shrine. Off you hop. And then now we can access the rooftops. And this allows us to get this little item here. Getting a longbow, that's nice. Dash off here. And shrine time. Ta-da! Alrighty, well, 37 and a half minutes, holy crap. Ugh, that's longer than I expected. Time flies when you're having fun, I swear. Alrighty, hope you're enjoying. Catch you all in the next one. Later.